Famous in Malaysia as well. So this dish, I learned how to make it from one of my aunts, and I'm just going to show you how to make the noodles and the sauce. It comes in two parts. First, you've got the rice noodles, so you've got a fried rice noodles, and then you've got a peanut sauce that goes on top of that. So let me show you what you're going to need to make the peanut sauce. So for the sauce, you're going to need some oil that we're going to for us to cook the sauce in. Then you're going to need 500 grams of onions that have been cut roughly, 150 grams of garlic, and 50 grams of dry chilies that have been soaked. These three ingredients will need to be ground together in a blender, and so that we get a nice smooth paste that we can use as a base for the sauce. Then next we're going to need one lime-sized ball of tamarind paste and half a cup of water to soak the tamarind paste in. So just pour the water over the tamarind ball and just let it soak for a while. And we've got 250 grams of roasted and unsalted peanuts that we need to grind as well in a little bit of water, and that's going to be added to the sauce later on. Then you've got some tauchu or soybean paste, and it comes in a bottle like this. This one is not blended or ground, so I had to grind it so that I could get a smooth paste like this. Then we will need about half a cup of coconut milk and some sugar and salt for taste. So let me show you what you're going to do next. So this is the ground onions, garlic, and dry chili. I've taken half of the amount for the noodles and kept it aside. And this is the other half that we're going to use for the sauce. And these are the ground peanuts. I ground it with a little bit of water so you can see it's not too runny and it's not too thick. Just put enough water so that the blender can actually grind the peanuts. Then with the tamarind, now it's softened and we can just extract the juice from there and just take out all the seeds. So just do that and then remove the seeds and keep it aside so that we can use it for the sauce. So now put some oil in your pot and let it get heated up, and then add your ground soybean paste or tauchu to the hot oil and fry it until it's nice and fragrant. Okay, now that it's nice and fragrant and it's cooked, we can add the chili, dry chili, onion and garlic paste. And we have to let this cook until the raw chili taste has gone and the smell has gone. So it'll take probably about 10 to 15 minutes for it to cook. So just let it boil on its own. You can cover it with a cover so that it doesn't splash all over your kitchen. And then just keep checking on it every now and then to make sure that it's not burning. So it's been about 10 minutes now since I put this on the stove. And you can see that the chili has cooked and it has thickened. So now add your tamarind juice. And about 2 teaspoons of sugar and 2 teaspoons of salt, and just let it cook for a few more minutes, and then we will add the peanut ground peanuts in and the coconut milk last. So now it's been a few minutes after I've added the tamarind juice and salt and sugar. Just add in your ground peanuts and stir that through, and it looks like this looks quite thick, so I'm going to add a little bit of water, but not too much at this point.
because we'll be adding the coconut milk as well, so we don't want the sauce to be too runny. So just let it cook for a few minutes and then we'll add the coconut milk. Now that we've added the peanut sauce, I'm going to add the coconut milk and just let it cook for a few more minutes. Just stir it through and then taste for salt and just check that it has enough salt. This is a good consistency, but it will thicken a bit. So I'm going to just add a little bit more water and just let it boil for a few more minutes and then I'll take it off the fire. For the second half of this dish, which is the fried noodles, you're going to need the other half of the ground paste that we kept aside earlier. Then you're going to need about 10 to 12 pieces of tofu pork. Tofu pork looks like this and it comes in a plastic bag, and I've just cut it up into thin slices like that. So just slice them up. And then you need about 5 or 6 pieces of fried tofu. You can get it in a plastic container, or you can buy fresh tofu. If you're going to buy fresh tofu, the big square ones, then maybe just 2 of those pieces would be enough. Deep fry it and slice it up into pieces around this size and keep that aside. Then you're also going to need a little bit of thin soy sauce and about 1/2 kilo of fresh bean sprouts. And you're also going to need chives. These are Asian chives. They are a bit flatter. They don't look like the normal chives that you get here in Australia, but these are easily available in many of the Asian shops. And lastly, you're going to need 1 packet, which is 500 grams of rice noodles. I have soaked the rice noodles in some warm water until they are like soft and easy to eat. So let me show you how to make this part of the dish. So again, like earlier, we need to cook the chili so that the raw taste is removed, and we also just cook the chili a bit more. So just add that to some hot oil and stir it and let it cook for about 10 minutes again. So it's been about 10 minutes since I put the chili, grounded chili paste on the stove. And I'm going to add a little bit of salt and just stir that through, and then add both the tofus in and stir it until it's evenly coated with the chili and just let it cook for about 2 minutes before we go to the next step. Next, we can add the mihun or the rice noodles and stir that through until it's evenly coated with the chili paste. Next, we're going to add the chives. The chives that I showed you earlier, I wanted to show you how it looks when it's whole. It's like this. It's quite flat, as you can see. And that's how it looks. And it has a whitish root. So yeah, we're gonna add the cut chives now and the bean sprouts. And then we're gonna stir that through until it's evenly cooked. Lastly, just add a bit of soy sauce to the noodles and stir that through, and just check for salt, but do remember that your sauce has salt as well, so you don't want the noodles to be too salty on their own, so just be aware of that when you're adding your salt and balancing your dish. So now we've completed the dish. This is how it looks. You've got your noodles and the sauce on top. So I've just poured the sauce on top. I've sprinkled a few chilies, fresh cut chilies. And to bring out the flavor a little bit more and add some acidity, you can use these little limes. They're called calamansi limes or limau kasturi. And you can just squeeze the juice on the top and then stir it through and enjoy your meal. Hope you like the video. Happy cooking!